how talented a lot of these Western Conference backcourts are like tonight. What have you done to kind of minimize the damage?
Just trying to blitz. You know, we tried to blitz and they made the right reads, and you know, our rotations weren't up to snuff, and you know, they just killed us all night.
Kobe, when you were that age, how long did it take you to feel like you knew what you were doing out there?
Well, a little faster, probably. I mean, I didn't have a choice. I mean, in this city with the players I was playing with and the coaching staff, it was like, you know, figure this out or your head's on a platter sort of thing. You know what I mean? So, but, you know, it took me probably a good year of playing.
You also didn't start, though.
Like, yeah, no, I didn't play. That's why, you know, a good year of playing. Like, so, you know, 99 is when I first started, you know, playing. That was a shortened season, so, you know. Year after that, Phil and them came on board, right? So it was really that season, and then, you know, I had up until the playoffs to figure it out.
Would it have happened faster if you'd been starting from the jump?
Like, oh, for sure. No, no, for sure, of course. Of course. I mean, I studied the game all the time, and I wanted to figure it out. It wasn't like I was resisting. It's just I couldn't make the reads. And then once I figured out how to make them, the game became much easier.
How much of it was just actually physically getting your body from being, in your case, 17, 18?
Yeah, that's a big difference. Yeah, it makes a big difference. I mean, you go from playing, you know, 30 games or whatever to, you know, playing that before All-Star break, you know what I mean? So it takes a toll on your body, and it takes a good year to really adjust and to figure out what you need to do from a weight training program and a diet and things like that. So.
Byron said that he really made a conscious effort tonight to get the ball to the end, right? Like, he's running the show now. Do you think that's important for him to be empowered?
Well, yeah, I mean, I think it's important for his growth. I mean, that's why we drafted him to be a point guard, right? I mean, that's why he's here. So, you know, it's important to let him do what he does best.
Is he ready for it?
Well, I mean, he's ready to take on that challenge, right? And the more he does it, the better he'll get at it, which is what we all want him to do.
Is there – the team has been in games for the most part, almost the whole season. It's not like you're getting blown out, but just can't finish. Is it – what's worse? I mean, is it good that you're in games, or is it bad that you can't finish?
It doesn't matter. You know, it's just a little mental mistakes at the wrong time. You know, defensive balance, wrong rotation here and there. That's really been, caving a roof in on us in the last – 5 minutes of ball game.
Are you getting satisfaction at all from this whole teaching thing?
Satisfaction? Yeah, I do. I mean, from trying to help the guys learn as much as I can, right? It'd be nice to have some wins to go along with that, but still in all, it is fun to share some of that knowledge.
What are the specific things maybe you've seen, like maybe say with the D'Angelo, where you see him do something on the floor and you go, okay, I see him progressing.
His pick and roll progressions are really good, you know, in terms of making the right reads and things like that, right? Now it's just a matter of consciously putting the defense at a deficit, you know, how to do that. Then defensively, getting over screens, how to navigate through those screens. You know, Gary Payton taught me how to do that in 2000, taught me how to get over those screens and, you know, how to body up a point guard and things like that. So just a matter of time for him to start figuring that out.